తస్మాత్ గురుం ప్రపద్యేత జిజ్ఞాసు శ్రేయ ఉత్తమం. ది శ్రీమద్ భాగవతం సేస్ వన్ షుడ్ వన్ మస్ట్ యాక్సెప్ట్ ఏ బోనఫైడ్ స్పిరిచువల్ మాస్టర్స్ గైడెన్స్ డైరెక్షన్ ఫార్ మేకింగ్ ఇంక్వైరీస్ అబౌట్ spiritual subject matter. Tad vijnanartham sa gurum eva abhigachet. To know about the absolute truth, to know about God, or to know about the self, one must approach a bona fide spiritual master. And the qualifications of a spiritual master are also mentioned. Samitpanihi Shrotriyam Brahmanishtam. The spiritual master must be Shrotriya. Shrotriya means he should have learned about the spiritual science from another bona fide spiritual master. And he should be Brahmanishtam. He should be fixed in the realization of the absolute truth. That means he should be fixed in Krishna consciousness himself, and he should be enlightened by another bona fide spiritual master. So the Bhagavad Gita says, Krishna says, that this transcendental knowledge is being spoken by Krishna to Arjuna not for the first time, but Krishna spoke the same transcendental knowledge millions of years back to the sun god Vivaswan. Imam Vivasvate Yogam Proktavan Aham Avyayam Vivaswan Manave Praha Manurikshvakave Bravit. The spiritual science is handed down from the beginning of creation through the first created being, Brahma. Brahma directly received the knowledge through his heart from Krishna directly. Similarly, Krishna has instructed so many others who are bringing down this knowledge. So Srila Prabhupada comes in a disciplic succession called the Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya or Parampara. So Prabhupada is bringing down this knowledge. So when he is writing a commentary on the Bhagavad Gita, a translation and purport, he is writing on the Bhagavad Gita, explaining the Bhagavad Gita, he is not presenting his own understanding or his viewpoint, as is normally the case done by somebody who writes a translation. Prabhupada is giving the parampara message as it is, as he has received it, without any change. So we can be confident that we are receiving the knowledge from Prabhupada. What was spoken, what was explained, what was taught by Krishna himself. So there is no difference between what Arjuna has understood directly from Krishna and what we understand from Prabhupada through this parampara system. The knowledge is the same, and the effect of that knowledge we can see before Srila Prabhupada actually started this Krishna consciousness movement. So many people have been studying Bhagavad Gita. So many editions of the Bhagavad Gita were already available all over the world, in so many languages. In English alone, before Srila Prabhupada's Bhagavad Gita was published, there were 270 odd translations and commentaries already available. So one lady asked Srila Prabhupada, what is the reason you are writing one more? Already so many are there. What is the necessity? So Srila Prabhupada explained to her, this lady who asked him this question, that as far as I can see, none of them are giving the parampara explanation. In each and every one of them, the author is expressing his or her view. Whereas I am writing this Bhagavad Gita to present the parampara message. So, the result is, we can clearly see the result. Anybody who reads Srila Prabhupada's Bhagavad Gita, they come to the same conclusion as Arjuna. Krishna tells Arjuna, become my devotee. So the result of reading Bhagavad Gita should be that one should become a devotee of Krishna. One should surrender to Krishna. That is the message of the Bhagavad Gita. So Prabhupada has clearly brought out that message. And Prabhupada demonstrated that in his personal life also. See, Guru is also called Acharya, one who teaches by his personal example. Srila Prabhupada is surrendered to his Guru and is teaching us also how to surrender to Krishna by his example through the disciplic succession. So for anybody who is interested in spiritual advancement, in spiritual life, they should approach a spiritual master who is described in the Shastra. And such a spiritual master for our time is Srila Prabhupada. Now some people may object that Prabhupada is no longer physically present. But Srila Prabhupada, even when he was present physically on this planet, he did not adopt the Gurukul system of teaching and training any students interested in Vedic wisdom. He was teaching and he was preaching and he was traveling constantly. In 12 short years, Srila Prabhupada established this worldwide Krishna consciousness movement or Hare Krishna movement, and he initiated more than 10,000 disciples. He established 108 Radha Krishna temples all over the world in all major cities. So all this he did not by personally instructing everybody physically. No. He taught through a system where one follows the instructions, beginning with chanting Hare Krishna, and some simple principles like hearing Bhagavatam every day, worshipping Krishna, accepting remnants of food offered to Krishna called prasadam, etc., which are all described in a book called Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu by Srila Rupa Goswami, one of the acharyas, who tells us in this age how we can practice the system of Bhakti Yoga to actually make spiritual advancement. So in that book called Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Srila Rupa Goswami says there are 64 principles for practicing Bhakti Yoga. The first principle is Adav Guru Ashrayam. One should first of all accept shelter of a bona fide spiritual master. Accepting shelter means you approach a bona fide spiritual master and request that the spiritual master gives you guidance personally for you to begin and practice and make advancement in spiritual life, in Bhakti Yoga. So, the principles already given, and Prabhupada made the system that his representatives, the devotees in the temple who are dedicated for practicing and preaching, actually guide anybody who is serious on behalf of Prabhupada. In this regard, the devotees are not actually becoming guru But they are actually presenting whatever Prabhupada has taught and strictly following all of Prabhupada's instructions. Anybody can take shelter of Prabhupada. The process is a transcendental process. Just like Krishna is not physically present, but Srila Prabhupada says anybody who studies Bhagavad Gita actually is, and following the instructions of Krishna from the Bhagavad Gita, is directly getting shelter of Krishna. Similarly, in a transcendental process, one can directly take shelter of the Guru if he gives the instructions to be followed by everyone who desires seriously to advance spiritually. So in this system, the first step is to take shelter of Srila Prabhupada by making commitment to agree to follow his instructions. So the first instruction Srila Prabhupada gives is chant Hare Krishna. And to actually chant Hare Krishna properly and to actually become free from certain old habits, we have to follow some additional principles. So since everybody cannot all of a sudden accept all the required principles for taking initiation from Srila Prabhupada formally, there are levels created whereby one gradually makes progress by accepting one or two or few principles at a time. Especially those who are not staying in the temple, along with your daily duties and responsibilities, especially family people, you can gradually accept one or two principles and make steady progress regardless of what your situation might be. It's not that somebody who can't give all their time for spiritual life cannot make progress. No, that's not what is being taught in the scriptures. In fact, Krishna was speaking to Arjuna, who was a family man who had so many responsibilities. So Krishna never told Arjuna, give up all your duties and then you just practice spiritual life. No. So Krishna is teaching something very practical in the Bhagavad Gita, that do your duties, but also side by side, you should accept some principles for practicing spiritual life. So the easiest thing to do in spiritual life, practice, spiritual practice, is to chant Hare Krishna. But to strengthen our chanting, there are a few other simple principles that you should accept. All this is very nicely outlined in the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu by Srila Rupa Goswami. So you'll be guided, if you begin by chanting Hare Krishna, you'll be guided step by step how you can make progress. And as much as you can really follow on a regular basis, because this regular practice is very, very important. It's not a something that we do once in a while casually. No, we seriously follow every day. And then we make very rapid progress if we follow every day. Even small, simple things as just like chanting 108 times, somebody does every day, strictly, sincerely. Very quickly you can make progress. You can yourself feel the change of heart. Bhakti is such a nice thing. In the Bhagavad Gita, it said, pratyakshavagamam dharmyam. It is directly experienced by the practitioner of bhakti. What is the transformation within the heart or the consciousness? So, as many of you already have experienced and you are feeling the necessity, absolute necessity of following the process by accepting the shelter of Srila Prabhupada. So today formally about 80 devotees will be accepting shelter of Srila Prabhupada and making commitments to follow, practice Prabhupada's instructions to get Prabhupada's blessings and make real advancement in Krishna consciousness under the guidance of Srila Prabhupada. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.